how are you? How's your day going? How's your week going? What have you been up to? I would love to know. Send me some messages, send me an email, send me some pictures, send me anything you like. I'd love to know how everything is going for you. And for those of you who've gone back to school this week, a very special hello, and I hope you're enjoying being back at school, and I hope you're enjoying seeing your teachers. Some of you will be seeing teachers for the first time, doing things for the first time, and that's quite exciting. First time in ages and ages, so that's really good, isn't it, to see people that you haven't seen for a while. So I do hope you're having a good week. It's a bit sad it started raining in a way, but also it's very good because the plants and the crops need it. I can't bring in any more my sunflower plants to show you how they're getting on because they've been sprouting up because they are now planted out in the garden. So I'd have to bring the whole garden in to show you, and that's not possible. But maybe when the sun is shining again, we might be able to go outside and see them growing. Now, I don't know if you've been growing anything, you've grown any seeds, but send me some pictures, send me some drawings. I would love to see them. So, for those of you who don't know, who've never joined me before, I am Reverend Sue, and I go into St John's School. I did go into St John's School. And do collective worship, but obviously we can't do that at the moment because we're all having to be really careful. So this is why I'm still doing collective worship, but doing it from my home. So this is my home. Normally there's a dog alongside, but actually she's over there behind the camera, so you can't see her. She's over there having a nice snooze. So before we do anything else, we're going to light a candle. I don't know if you can see this candle. I hope you can see this candle. I'm going to light this candle and I'm going to say a prayer. Now, lighting a candle reminds us that God is with us. And we can't see God, which is why we light a candle, because that flame reminds us that God, who is warmth and light and powerful and kind, is with us all the time. So let's say a prayer. Dear God, thank you that you are kind and loving, and you give us guidance on how to live our lives. And we ask that we can learn something a little bit today about how we might live our lives well, how we might live our lives to help other people and to make the world a wonderful, kind place. So help us to be kind and help us to love other people and to love you. Amen. So the story that we're doing today is the 10 best ways, and you might know this as the 10 commandments, and this is a story again from the desert. And really, the 10 commandments, which are advice on how to live a good life, they all kind of summed up in one way, which is about love, which is about loving other people and loving God. So that's why it says, all you need is love here. And I'm going to sing a song, and we're going to have some words up on the screen, and there will be a little bit, which I hope you'll be able to join in, which is very, very simple, where it just says, all you need is love. And we do that a couple of times, so hopefully by the time we've done it a second time, you'll be able to join in. But this is a song, it's a very old song, by a band called The Beatles. And they wrote this song in the year that I was born. So I think this is a very, very special song. So we're going to have the words up on the screen. And we're going to sing, all you need is love. Love, 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 love. Nothing you can sing that can be sung. Nothing you can say, but you can learn how to play the game. It's easy. Nothing you can make that can be made. No one you can save that can be saved. Nothing you can do, but you can learn how to play it for you in time. It's easy. So it's time for our story. This is the desert. It is a dangerous place. People do not go into the desert unless they have to. There is no water there. And without water, we die. There is no food, and without food, we die. When the wind blows, it changes the shape of the desert. People get lost. Some never come back. In the daytime, the sun is so hot that people must wear lots of clothes to protect themselves from the sun and the blowing sand. The sand stings when it hits your skin. The sun scorches you by day. And at night it is very cold. You need many clothes to keep warm. The desert is a dangerous place. People only go there if they have to. The people of God went through the water into freedom. They were free, so Miriam led the dancing. Now that the people were free, they can go anywhere. They can go anywhere they want and do anything they want to do. So where should they go now? What should they do? What is the best way? God loved the people so much that God gave them the 10 best ways to live. Sometimes these are called the 10 commandments. As the people travelled across the desert, they followed fire by night and smoke by day. They began to complain. Some even wanted to go back to Egypt. There was not enough food, there was not enough water. God helped Moses find food and water. And finally, they came to the great mountain. People came close to the mountain, but they were afraid to touch it. Mount Sinai was covered with fire and smoke. Moses was the only one who had the courage to climb up into the fire and smoke to meet God. When Moses was on top of the mountain, he came so close to God, and God came so close to him, that he knew what God wanted him to do. God wanted him to write the 10 best ways to live on stones and bring them down the mountain to the people. God gave the 10 commandments to Moses. Moses gave them to the people, and the people gave them to us. Here are the 10 best ways. Love people. Love God. When we put the 10 best ways all together, this is what they tell us. Love God. Love people. God loves us. Love God, love people, God loves us. When we say us, we mean God's love for each one of us, as well as all of us together. Don't serve other gods. Commandment 1. Make no idols to worship. Commandment 2. Be serious when you say my name. Commandment 3. Keep the Sabbath holy. commandment for. Honour your parents. Commandment 5. Don't kill. Commandment 6. Don't break your marriage. These are hard, aren't they? Sometimes, even though we might want to keep them, sometimes we just can't. And sometimes marriages go wrong. And sometimes it's not possible to keep it. Don't steal. Commandment 8. Don't lie. Commandment 9. Don't even want what other people have. Commandment 10. They are hard, aren't they? When we really think about them. But God did not say, these are the 10 easy things to do. They are the 10 best ways. They are called the 10 commandments. They are hard, perhaps even impossible. But we are supposed to try. They mark the best way, like stones marking the best path. Now I wonder, which of these do you like the best? Which do you like the best? Which would be the easiest to do? Which would be the most difficult? I wonder which is the most important of all of these. I wonder which one is especially for you. Which part of the story is especially for you? I wonder if there are any of these, of the 10 commandments, the 10 best ways that we could leave out and still have everything that we need. That is a lot to think about, isn't it? That's a lot to wonder about. I wonder what these people thought about it. So I'm going to put on the Facebook page, I'm going to put the 10 commandments. And if you like, you could create your own box of the 10 best ways and put them on heart shapes to remind you that these are for us because God loves us. and God says, this is the best way to live. This is the best way to help us to love God and to love people. So as we finish, we're going to pray, and we're going to pray about love. And I'm going to say a prayer that will allow you to pray for somebody that you love. And you can say their name at the point where I leave a space. So let's put our hands together and perhaps close our eyes. God, who loves us, thank you that you do not leave us adrift, wondering what is the best way to live our lives, but that you give us help and guidance, and that you do that because you love us and you want us to love each other. So we pray for everybody in the world, particularly people who are having a hard time. And now I invite you to pray for a special person. So, loving God, please bless and care for keep them safe. Amen. Thank you very much for joining me. And if you are joining me later, or if you're watching this video later, then please do maybe leave a comment and let us know that you were watching and that you were with us, whether it was live or later on. And also, if we could have my email address up, if I could have my email address up on the screen. If you want to email me with any pictures or thoughts or prayers, then please do so, or leave me a message on Facebook. And I will see you next week. God bless. Bye. Oh, can't get up.